Well, season's greetings once again, my friends. I'd like to welcome you to another video. And this video is going to be my favorite subject, Star Trek. Now, there are a lot of things that, when it comes to Star Trek, remind me of my childhood. The models, definitely. The show itself, the kits. AMT played a big role in my childhood when it comes to Star Trek. And I got something that's so cool to show you guys today. I'm always on a lookout for little Star Trek goodies. And when I saw this, I was like, oh, this was just so cool. And it exceeded my expectations, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But I'm talking about the Star Trek, the Tiny TV Classics. The best clips from Star Trek, and guys, check out that TV. I mean, how cool is that? I mean, Star Trek was on the air when I was born, but I was too young. It was more of the reruns that I remember watching, but it was a very, very, very similar set to this. And this, when I saw this, I was just like, this is so cool. But I gotta tell you, what else? It really exceeded my expectations, because I expected a TV to show pictures. But there's a little try me function on the side, and when I actually got it in, check this out.
You're bluffing. Vulcans never bluff.
I mean, how cool is that? This thing is so cool. And it's got a remote. Now, I don't know if they had remote controls back then. In the 60s. I want to say no, but I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't remember having a remote, but look at the TV. That is so cool. And this is licensed exclusively for Walmart. And they did have a couple of these that are available. I'll put the link if you want to check it out. They had, again, for the 60s, they had Batman. And I do like Batman, the real Batman with Adam West. But you guys that follow my channel know that it's not even close. If I'm going to choose Star Trek or Batman, maybe at some point we can do another one. But this is for Star Trek. The TV is so cool. And we got Captain Kirk on the front of the box. And again, this is licensed exclusively for Walmart. Really cool. You can see the top scenes on tiny screens. And for some reason, when they shipped it, they like to ship things in a plastic envelope. So the box is a little bit smashed up. On the side of the box, we have Dr. McCoy. You can see he's holding something in his shot. I'm a doctor, not a... And I could think almost immediately that's the, a couple have come to mind, because we saw the Doomsday Machine, and when Captain Kirk, when they're aboard the Constellation, and Captain Kirk goes, Bones, do you know what the Doomsday Machine is? And he goes, no, I'm a doctor, not a mechanic. Also, in Mirror, Mirror, where they're on the Enterprise, or the ISS Enterprise in the alternate universe, and they need to work together, but the landing party, but the captain would be too suspicious to be working closely in engineering. So Dr. McCoy becomes an engineer. Scotty recruits him. Anyway, those are the first two that come to mind, but you can see Dr. McCoy is on this side of the box. And on this side of the box, we have Mr. Spock. Vulcans never bluff. And of course, he's talking to Commodore Decker. Because Commodore Decker had used regulations to take over command of the Enterprise while Captain Kirk was still on the Constellation with Mr. Scott and the away team trying to get it going. And Mr. Spock had threatened to put Commodore Decker under arrest, and he didn't want to do that. And Commodore Decker, he looks at him and goes, you're bluffing. And that's when Mr. Spock goes, Vulcans never bluff. We got some more information on bottom of the box. This was released in 2021. You can see the website, tinytvclassics.com. and has a bunch of licensing information. Basic Fun, a Basic Fun logo. Package design, product support. And let's take a look at the back. You can see, again, I love that TV. And look, we've got the Gorn from the classic episode Arena. Best clips, famous quotes, full color TV. And they have other TVs. I love the back. Look, the back is the back of the TV. That's what the box is, and I love the setup. We've got the 70s and 80s retro, classic 90s, the 2000s, and the millennial TVs. They actually even have some for like movies. They have, I saw a Jaws, TV shows. They have South Park. They've got all kinds of things for this. And you can see them opening the door with this, because this would be pretty cool to do like a retro Christmas. Maybe Charlie Brown or the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer and other specials. Anyway, this is for Star Trek. And when I saw this, I had to get it. And again, this exceeded my expectations, because I thought it was going to be pictures that flash, not actual video. How cool is that, man? Okay, let's take it over to the desk where there's more light, and we're going to unbox it and check it out. Okay, there's a lot more light and more room over here. You can see how really cool that looks. Let's go ahead and open it up. I'm gonna put the box aside. All right. Let's see, we got, oh, look at that. I didn't even see how cool that looked. Look at the background. We've got the console. We got Mr. Sulu and Mr. Chekhov. And we've got the Klingon D7 battle cruiser. Love it. Wow, I didn't even notice that. That's so cool. All right, let's put that over there. We do have a booklet. Tiny TV Classics Instruction Manual. Let's see. Thank you for purchasing your brand new Tiny TV Classics. Please use this guide to help you set up your TV and familiarize yourself with the controls of the TV unit and of the controller. You can see where it's got the little reset. There are buttons on both sides, channel up, channel down. On the right-hand side of the TV, the power, volume up and volume down are on the left side of the TV. You can see where the battery door is. And on the remote, it shows you the power button is to the upper right, and the play is to the upper left. Volume up and volume down is on the bottom, and a channel up and channel down are the middle buttons. No cables necessary. After pulling out the Try Me tab in the back of the unit, simply press the power button on the side of the unit to turn the unit on. Look at, we can go TV surfing. Press channel up or channel down to flip through the channels. either of the TV unit or with the remote control, press the volume up and volume down buttons to adjust the volume, either on a TV unit or with the remote control. I love it. Look, it's got the little graphics. The unit will cycle through channels and loop back to the first channel. After you get to the last channel, no signal screen will appear. Look at the no signal when it's going to go to sleep after. You guys may not remember, the younger people, but the TV stations, they would play the national anthem and then they would sign off the air. Of course, now 24 hours a day, they have things on. You can go to sleep mode. After a few minutes, the unit will go into sleep mode to conserve battery power. When it's in sleep mode, the TV unit can only wake up by either pressing the power button or the TV unit, the remote, within the first 2 minutes of the sleep mode. After that, only the power button on the TV unit will work to wake up the TV. And on the back, it shows you the batteries. It looks like it takes 3 AAA. And we have the small button battery. It looks like it's got 2 of those in the remote. And you can see some of the information. Okay, so that's said and done. We got to check this out. All right, is this taped? Looks like this is taped as well. So let's go ahead and we just need to cut one side. Look at the remote. I love it. You can see the back, the buttons. Looks like the batteries are already in it and there's no tab to pull. I don't see one. Now let's put that to the side for a moment. And let's get the TV out. Love it. And you can see there's a tab in the back. There's also some tape. Let's see if we can get that tape off. The tape is what's holding the tab in place. So, yeah. Pulled out the tab. That's everything that's in here. Let's get that out of the way and check out the TV. You can see the on-off switch and the volume up and down. And you can see the channel. And there's a little reset button if we need to reset it. And it looks like the speaker is on this side of the TV. Look at the box, the housing for the picture tube. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. And we got some numbers on the bottom. Item number 06911. And this one is 33521YS. This is so cool. All right, let's put this to the side. And you know what? Let's zoom in up on this for you guys. Let's try pushing the power button on a TV first.
Novelist will write a classic using that theme. You recommend those three words even over
I love you.
Answer it you now.
Carl, it's my name. Carl, nothing else. Carl. You're bluffing. Hawkins never bluff.
How cool is that? How cool is that? So let's see if the remote, if we can do that again. See, we're going through the channels. All right. I'm gonna show you guys the remote. Laylock.
I'm a surgeon, not a psychiatrist.
Imposter is not to be injured. Use minimum force. Repeat. Imposter is not to be injured.
Of course, that was on Vulcan. That was to Pring.
Why? Within 8 days. Explain. I don't know.
Pon Farr.
Keep saying that. Are you a doctor, aren't you?
That's when to Pring chose Captain Kirk as her potential mate for Mr. Spock to fight to the death. This is so cool. All right, let's try to put the volume up.
One bar 6-7.
Here we go. Let's try to pause it. So you can actually pause the action with the remote. Devil in the Dark, and referring to the Horda. And of course, the Tribbles on Space Station K7. The Romulan Commander in Balance of Terror. And of course, Baylock. We can pause it. I wish they would have more of the ships.
I'm a surgeon. The imposter is not to be injured. Look, I'm a doctor, not a...
So it looks like it goes up to 20. We have 20 channels. And you can see, you can put the volume down. And you can go in reverse. We can pause the no signal screen. That's pretty cool. This is so cool. And then, when you're done watching, you can put it. See, when you put it off, you remember? Those of you my age, you remember when you put the TV off, there's that little dot in the screen that just kind of stayed a while. let's widen this out a bit. This is so cool. This is really so much fun. Let's take a look at the TV. You can see the dials. You turn the dials on the top, and there was that fine tuning knob. When I was a kid, there was a box on top of the TV that had a dial. And let's say you turned it four spots. You push it in and turn the dial until it went four spaces over, and the box would blink every time the unit turned. So it would go like one, two, three, four. And what it was actually doing was on the antenna on the roof was actually rotating in order to get the signal better. And the buttons on the bottom, that you had the color, the tint. I think one was blue, yellow, and the one on the end was red. And this is just this is so cool. Oh man, there's another one of those childhood little fun things, just to reminisce, you know, because we've all the technology that we have now. And I mean, let's face it, we can do more on an iPhone now that they could do with a computer that took up a whole room. So this was technology has certainly changed. But this TV, this is just so cool. When I saw this, I thought this was wonderful. And again, we got the helm, and looks like the Klingons are around. Red alert, shields up. I absolutely think this is fantastic. So I think I'm gonna zoom in. We'll go through the channels one more time. Make sure that you guys be able to see it. Now let's put it on. Oh, you got to put it on with the TV.
Boldly go where no man has gone before. you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
I know this saying. It was invented in Russia.
Let me help. 100 years or so from now, I believe, a famous novelist will write a classic using that theme. You recommend those three words even over I love you.
Centuries from now?
God, it's my name. God, nothing else. God. You're bluffing. Rockets never bluff.
That is so cool. That is so cool. Zoom back out. And again, the knobs on the front, it just brings back so many memories. Because this larger one, you had, okay, this is what you had the setup with. You had like the major networks, and that was channel 1 through 12, I think, or 1 through 13. But then you had the UHF channels, which I think was 20 and up, and that was on a separate dial. Of course, younger viewers have no idea what I'm talking about, but you had the larger dial was for like channel 4, channel 2, channel 10, channel 4, things like that. And when I was a kid, the UHF at the time, I think WSBK TV 38, is where I'd watch the Red Sox, whereas the Patriots were on, and they weren't on every week. They were only on once in a while, and that was on the major networks. But the Red Sox were on WSBK, and I remember we had WLVI channel 56. I used to like that because it had Benny Hill, and we had channel 27, and I don't remember the call letters for that, but that's what I was able to watch Space 1999 on. Whereas the Doctor Who, I was introduced to the fourth Doctor on Channel 2. So, giving my age away. So, my friends, I hope you enjoy this little trip down memory lane with this. I mean, this is just so cool. This was a lot of fun. And who knows, maybe we can get another one, a different show or movies or, you know, we'll see. But anyways, my friends, I hope you enjoy this little review of this pretty awesome kit. And it was really inexpensive. I think it was like $20. It really was worth it. It's really fun. So my friends, until the next video, I'll talk to you soon, and thank you so much for watching.